Okay, so the hero's at the source of the zombie outbreak.
No humans around, right? No dialogue, just a zombie massacre.
Just a zombie massacre? There's these mutation stations, and goo, and mayhem! So, a gas truck leaked gas, and now it's a road of fire, baby!
But what does this mean to the hero?
The fire represents their anger issues. Instead of dealing with it, they're avoiding it.
Okay.
Okay, so then there's a flipped train. Wait a minute! It's a fucking flipped gas tanker! The explosion will make people shit themselves!
Is there a way to show something about the main character?
We are! They know how to explode things. The hero's gotta find a way down. If you were to put the story beats on a graph, this would be the low point in the movie and, the bridge.
In my career.
You say something?
Nope.
Now, the hero finds themselves with literally nowhere to go. Literally.
Maybe we can hear the hero's inner monologue. There's despair, loss.
Or they can just use a cool grappling hook! And our hero sees a giant cage. What was in it?
Maybe the cage can remind the hero of their time as a prisoner of war.
Sure.
And the zombies here represent, I don't know, the people they saw die.
Interesting.
Okay, so the hero has to cut through a homeless hideout inside the bridge. Zombies are there having a freaking zombie feast!
What are you trying to say here about the homeless issue?
That homelessness is bad!
Really going out on a limb with that, huh?
But look, homelessness is a real important issue for me. I want everyone in the world to have a home and a shelf filled with Blu-rays of all the movies I make! And then the main character gets to the ammo drop, and there's da-da-da-da! Ha-ha! A new gun! One more character? How about a fucking zombie Sasquatch character? Boom! Plot twist! In your bite your face, zombie! Our hero has to get to the ammo drop.
Or else they die and become the enemy. Okay, yeah, I'm seeing this.